If you want to match up the beat of the music to your video, look no further. Your boy's got your back, and I'm bringing it to you once again in CyberLink PowerDirector 13 Ultimate. Let's get into it. Hello, my beautiful Power Director peeps. Let's get our beat sync on, shall we? As you can see, I have an audio clip down in the timeline track. You can tell that because it is a waveform only. There are no scenes from a video clip above that. If you right click on any clip that is audio only, you will get an option called Use Automatic Music Beat Detection. I'm going to click on this option. Now you got a lot of great instructions here. You got a timeline here with your waveform. You got your navigation buttons to play, stop, pause, back, forward, all your little keyframes here, zoom in, zoom out, the timeline, timestamps. And then you have your automatic music beat detection here. So you have a minimum time between beat markers, which would be 2 seconds. You can change that if you want. If you click on the detect button, it'll detect those beats with a minimum of 2 seconds or 1 second, whatever you choose. And then you have the option to manually add the timeline markers for the beats. If you have something that has a lot of beats in it, then you can use detect if you want to, but you might get a little bit of overlapping and a little randomness to your beats. If you like that, cool. For example, if I were to hit detect now, you'll notice that some of the markers are closer than others. There's little gaps in some of them. They're right on top of each other in some places. Now, it makes sense for them to be some gaps, because here you might say it should be a gap because there's not a lot of beat or music going on here. But then you got gaps in other places where it's like, what's up with that? What's going on there? Why is this gap small here? Stuff like that. So for me, I like to add my own beats manually. And if you got rhythm, you can do it too. So I'm gonna click on cancel so it does not add these timeline markers to my timeline. I'm gonna right click on the clip again. Go to use automatic music beat detection. And now I'm gonna click on the play button. Then I'm gonna bring my mouse here to where it says add. Now, you can also use the A button on your keyboard. If you feel better with the keyboard, you could just hit the A button, or you can left click with your mouse on the add button here. So I'm going to click play and get it going. Now, if you didn't like how it went, like if you said, there's a big gap there, I don't like that, guess what? You can click on one of them and then click on delete. Then I can actually go back, hit play again. And if I like that better, I can leave that there. So you can make changes to it, all of that goodness. It's a beautiful thing, isn't it? If you like how it looks, go ahead and click on apply. It will add them to your timeline, as you can see below. Now I have my timeline stretched out so you can see a big difference in where they are. Now all you need to do is add your clip. So I have 4 clips here, and I'm going to click on one of them with the left click of my mouse. Then I'm going to hold down my control key on my keyboard, and I'm going to click on these three. I'm going to hold my left mouse down, and I'm going to drag all of them down into track one. So now all four of these clips are on track one. Now I'm going to scrub my playhead to find a place where I would like to transition between the scenes and where I would like a beat to kind of drop. And this looks pretty good here. It's like a basket was finally made. So I'm gonna click on this clip and then I'm gonna click on split. Now I'm gonna click on the clip and I'm going to place my cursor at the beginning of the clip to where I see these two thick arrows. And I'm gonna just drag this over and do trim only. And I'm gonna drag it over some more, and I'm gonna do trim and move clips. So move everything over, and then I'm gonna move this one right to the beginning. I'm gonna trim it some more until I get to that position where I made my split. Now I'm gonna do trim and move clips. The reason why the first time I did trim only is because I wanted to be a space between the two clips. So I'm going to do trim and move clips again. And I'm going to do trim and move clips one more time. Now, I want to match this back part of this clip up to the beginning of the timeline marker. What that means is that's exactly where the clip is going to stop. So if I move this up until I see a little black line below the clip that goes all the way down through the timeline tracks, I know I'm lined up perfectly. So now I'm going to let go of my mouse, and now I'm going to trim the front to the beginning of the video. And so now I should have it perfect where it goes and stops right at that timeline marker point. All right, so I'm going to delete this clip. So I'm going to click on the trash bin. I'm going to do remove and fill gap. And now I have the next clip that I want to play with here. So I'm going to scrub the timeline until I find another point where I want to make a transition. So I'm going to click here. Now I'm going to click on split. Going to go back to the beginning here. Move this over a little. And I'm going to trim this one. Trim and move clips. Do it again. Let me move this one over some. And I'm going to move this into position once again until I see the black line is lined up. I'm going to pull this to the next one. And you just keep doing that. So remember, the key is always to make it a little bit smaller so that you can line up the back end and then pull the front end to match up to the next clip. And here's just a quick example what it'll look like. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy, BeatSync. In CyberLink PowerDirector 13 Ultimate. Alright guys, you know the routine. The thumb, the one that's pointed in the upward direction,
Click it, like it, live it, love it, hug it. Show the thumb some love. Comments. You know I love comments. So leave your comments below. You got questions? I'll answer them. If I can't answer them, I'll point you in the right direction to get you the help you need. Subscribe. Click on a little button to the side. And if you want some more YouTube love, all you gotta do is watch these videos. Watch these videos. You guys know what to do, so get to clicking.